are some stocks to watch out for. We're monitoring shares of BlackBerry after it reported a robust fourth quarter. BlackBerry shares rose 7% in the pre-market. Also in focus, shares of Levi Strauss, which hiked its guidance on full-year earnings that topped analysts' expectations. Shares of the clothing company surged 9% before the bell. We're also keeping a close watch on shares of Volvo Cars after it announced it sold a record number of cars in March, boosted by the launch of its electric SUV. This sent the stock higher by 7%.
Happy ending for Walt Disney CEO Bob Iger and other board members as they survive a battle against activist investors. Here's the full story.
Walt Disney shareholders have backed Chief Executive Bob Iger and other company directors, defeating a campaign by activist investors who argued the entertainment giant has underperformed in the streaming television era. Wednesday's vote to re-elect all 12 of Disney's current board members ended the year's most expensive and closely watched boardroom fight. It was launched by billionaire Nelson Peltz and Blackwell's Capital, who were seeking 5 seats between them on Disney's board. With that battle over, Disney's hunt for a successor to Iger kicks into high gear. The board has extended his retirement 5 times, and his new date is by the end of 2026. Members sought to reassure shareholders ahead of Wednesday's vote that they now take the matter seriously and are vetting candidates. Iger, meanwhile, has a window to execute a recovery, analysts say, by making the streaming television unit profitable and launching an app for Disney's flagship ESPN Sports Network. Iger said with the, quote, distracting proxy contest now behind Disney, it would focus on growth and value creation as well as creative excellence. Peltz's and Blackwell's bids were separate and competing, but both argued the $225 billion media company has bungled its CEO succession plans, lost its creative spark, and failed to properly harness new technology.
A look now at Asian markets. They ended Thursday trade on a positive note after Fed Chief Jerome Powell reaffirmed the possibility of a rate cut this year. Japan's Nikkei 225 snapped a 3-day losing streak, while the South Korean Kospi surged 1.3% on expectations tech giant Samsung Electronics will report a 9-fold increase in its first quarter profit. Here at home, Philippine shares bucked the region-wide rally with the main index falling for a third straight day.
A couple of days ago, we thought that the market was going to break out of that range, you know, when we broke above the 7,000 level. But unfortunately, the bulls couldn't follow through and we experienced some selling and profit-taking again. So we're back in the lower end of that range. But the behavior of the market in the last 2 days has been a little bit worrying, I think. I think we're kind of vulnerable to possibly break that 6,800 level. So we'll see.